We were just at negotiating, and we'll go into non-public afterwards and talk about that a little bit, after we finish up our budget stuff. So we got version two after we discussed version one and made the changes to version one that we wanted. The biggest change is that it what became known that we are going to have less state revenue coming in than we had before. So while our overall budget is actually less than it was last year, the revenue is also considerably less than we had last year. So the net result is an increase of what we have to put out on the taxpayers. And that's summarized in that first page, that the 107 page that we wrote.
And that is because why?
Yeah, so that's a very good question. I actually went and spent some time with Marie and Connie. It's the adequacy aid is the big piece of it that the state decides. And it's a very complex formula. Marie was kind enough to show me like the spreadsheet, and it has about across the top, it has about, I don't know, 10 to 15 things that go into the formula, but it's things like number of students that are receiving special education, students are receiving free and reduced lunch. There's a whole bunch of things that go into it. And I believe for all of it, it's the K through 6 students that are counted for Rollinsford.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's not students we tuition out to another district. We don't get adequacy aid for those.
That's just for this.
Right. Which is good to know, because I have had a Marshwood board member say, well, if we took your foreign exchange student, you'd be getting the state money for them. And it's like, no, we don't get state money for students that we tuition out. So
does Marshall get
that money? I believe they do not for us. But it would be interesting to ask them if they actually get the main stipend for the students they have. I don't know if they do or not.
I don't think so.
I don't think they do.
No. I don't think so.
Okay. And I agree, I don't think they do, but if we can double check them, send me the email. So it's a very complex formula. And the interesting part, so the state estimates what that's going to be in October. So last, they estimated it, and then they're going to do a final thing in September when the year closes. So they estimated it in October. They're going to do a final thing in September when it closes. Now, if they have somehow managed not to charge, if they've given us too much, we have to give it back. If they haven't given us enough, they will pay us, but only if they have the money. They don't have to pay us. Am I explaining that correctly, more or less?
Well, yeah. In the current year, the year that we're in now, we actually budgeted less, and then it's only like $2,000 difference. And then when we got the one in October to set the tax rate, it was actually $2,000 more than we had budgeted, what that they initially had said.
So we actually got a break.
A little bit more.
We got like a $2,000 break this year.
Well, they didn't give it to us. It was based on a revision of the formula. They didn't give it to us. It's still the same formula. They just revised it based on more current information. With the one that they do for budgeting purposes is estimated.
Which is what, so it's been estimated for the fiscal year 19, which is the budget we're working on.
But we won't know for sure what that is until
next September.
Okay, hey, that's helpful.
Yeah. Okay. All right, so hopefully that...
So we didn't have that number in version one. We didn't have that number in version one. So we got the information, so it was...
That's the big change.
That's why the 130,600 less than that.
Well, if you look at this sheet here, the summary sheet, it actually shows what the reduction is. That's the first.
That's the revenue. That's the revenue sheet, right?
I know, this is mine. This is what I'm looking at. So what page is
that? That's at the very back. It's where
just after the chart.
It's after the green copy, where it's the total budget. It's in the back, right behind the green copy.
Okay, so I know it's in the corner.
And that's the revision. So you can see what the loss of revenue is.
Oh, you just had it.
I'm gonna move that sheet closer to the front.
This is the right one, right?
You got it.
You moved it.
I did.
We were talking to Judy, but the packet's not, it's not moved in the packet, there you go. So that's a big change.
Yeah.
It doesn't change what we believed at the first round, last time we talked, of what we believe should be in the budget. It doesn't change what we should be in the budget, it just changes what's we're gonna have to put out for.
Changes what, like $17,000?
No, considerably more than that. It's, thought it was more like $60,000.
Yeah.
It is $60,000.
Yeah, $60,000, $59,000.
Yeah, 113 and that, well, you're right, it wasn't that much, it was more like $25,000 compared to the one. Although there were, and there were other.
Right.
Changes.
The other part, the other one was the, sped caddy change also.
Okay.
Went down about $15,000, $16,000?
Yeah, $16,000. So there's two components.
So what makes us, I mean, the difference between version one and version two in revenue is about $17,000.
Right.
I didn't have that first sheet, I had that something.
Yeah, we, yeah, went from.
It went from $113,000 to $130,000 less than, which is where I was saying $17,000.
Right.
So what else, what?
The other thing that changed is that the budget also changed because we clarified some things.
But this is just revenue.
Yes, that's just revenue, correct.
So, but I'm not seeing an increase in any revenue.
There is.
Well, the decrease.
That revenue.
It's $130,000 less.
So this is $113,000 less, that is $130,000 less, so that's a loss of $17,000. It's a loss of revenue.
Right, but if the state adequacy is $60,000, where are we making up that extra $43,000? You know what I'm saying?
The difference is coming out of the town. We have to make up the difference somewhere. It's gotta come out of the town. So in the version one, the CAT A or special education, we budgeted 45. We went from 45 to 35. That's a $10,000 difference there. Okay?
Do we have the same sheet in this in version one?
Yeah.
It's here.
It's not, no, I didn't put it, no, I didn't put that same sheet. That was something Connie has suggested to put in.
Okay, no worries. I'm just trying, do you know, do you get what I'm trying to figure out?
Yeah, so I have it right here. This is version one.
Okay.
This is version two.
Got it.
Look at the difference on the side.
So. It's less $30,000 in the town operation.
We just changed the way it went. So just look here. So, the town is giving us more money because we need more money to cover the difference. This is version one, so the town has to make up the difference.
Make up the difference in revenue.
That's right. Here was 85, here's 85. This is 2,200, this is 2,200. We had nothing here.
Mm-hmm.
We had, what was this to say, 59?
59,592.
So here's 600. So there's, we gained some money there. Here.
Adequate education.
Here was 35.
45.
45, so we reduced that by 10.
Okay.
The state's saying $500, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then this is where the other change is here. You see it?
This is Medicaid.
Yeah. Then there's another $10,000 there, right? What was there?
$10,000.
Okay, so it stayed the same. So it's basically, it's the CAT A and the, CAT A and the adequacy aid. Those are the two changes, and then the difference was made up at the, for the, from the town.
From the town.
From the town, yeah.
Okay.
Keeping it the same.
So.
I guess I just don't understand the semantics of that.
Well, and I know, it does, it is.
If it's coming from the town, isn't that, like, it's all coming from the town?
No, so it has to be raised from the, raised by taxes. So this is raised by taxes, and these are other sources to come up with, to come up with the same thing as your appropriations. Your appropriations and your revenue have to be the same.
So the town's coming up with another $90,000. So if you look under revenue.
By tax.
First line, yes.
Yes.
So under FY19, the plus 90, that's the difference.
That's on that sheet.
That's on the front sheet.
That's revenue two. But she was comparing version one to version two. Version two is the must apply.
Right here, top.
I see, yeah.
Yes.
That's the difference, right.
This is the next one, that's actually.
Which we figured out how to read it, which is an excellent job.
It's helpful.
Yeah.
Because you have to take out the transfer from last year from the trust funds.
What?
That's part of it too.
Well, yeah, but that was also there, version one was also, it was there, we were just, she was, Emily was comparing version one to version two.
Okay. I see.
And so when I looked at version one versus version two, I'm kind of only seeing as far as expenditures, the increases in insurance, and the only other difference.
SAU.
SAU.
Assessment that we didn't have.
Right, that was added. Maybe we got clarification on some of the custodial services.
Well, yeah, but the maintenance line, remember Kate had updated what the phone system was, and we kind of increased that a little bit, remember that?
But as far as any of the other numbers, they all were pretty close to the same.
We didn't change the tuition.
Right.
That stayed the same.
So the big change really was just the percentage increase.
The decrease in revenue.
The health increase was 3.1%, it was pretty reasonable. There are times when it's been, one year it was 17%.
Right.
Lord, really?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, that was because.
Because one year we got a negative number, and that makes a difference.
So.
You want to see this? You want to have version two?
Oh, it's actually estimated 3.5, and now it's 3.1.
That was the.
Yeah, yes, so that went down a little bit in version two.
That's your problem.
That is my problem.
So that revenue stuff is really completely out of our control.
We didn't have the number.
Yes.
Version one, we didn't have the number.
We thought it wasn't big.
That's completely up to the state in terms of how they fund it, and it's based on the number of students and your EDM and those sorts of things, but it is out of our control. As is CAPE.
Yeah. So, I mean, so the good news is, I mean, the budget compared to last year is down $40,000, over $40,000, or 0.7%, but we don't have the same revenues that we had last year, so it looks like a big increase in the budget. So, I mean, I don't know if we want to talk about anything else in particular. One of the things, you know, we've been trying to get a handle on special education payments to Marshwood. And I think the contract was written that we pay special education twice a year, or three times a year, but what has now been worked out, and we signed a memorandum of understanding with Marshwood on this, is that we will now be billed monthly, And that will allow us to keep a very better eye, and it'll be encumbered or unencumbered as necessary as we go through the year, so we'll know exactly where we stand with that going on. As Marie reminded me, we knew this, some of this billing, especially special ed, was going to be a real process, a real transition. So it's taken us a number of years to get to where we can start. And now the monthly billing is taking place now. It has started now. So that's good. So we're going to get a handle on it with this year's budget, and it will go forward that way as monthly billing. And I believe tuition is also being done monthly now. Is that correct? And that's good, too, for when students move in and out, it's easier to keep track of it. So that'll be a much more closely accounted figure, which is good. I think that'll be good going forward. So I appreciate the work you all did on getting that done. We did have a jump in special ed. I believe we have a known out-of-district placement in FY19.
And, I think so.
And yes. That must also begin us this year as well, is my guess. Anyway, I'm assuming it's hitting us this year too, so we have to, and it's not accounted for in this year's budget. So
do you know what $90,000
means on? We just did the math. We're at about
15 to 30.
So it's about 45 cents per thousand. More like 75 cents.
I have the tax rate with me. Is that wrong? It's not that I can do the math right now. Yeah, the tax rate for local education is 15.44.
We have to divide it first. So
what?
Divide it.
I don't think that's the number to use.
Yeah, I don't think it is either now that I look at it.
It's based on last year's. So anyway, all right. So anyway, we'll know all that shortly. It's at some point once we finalize them.
I doubled it by mistake.
Well, that's being cautious. I kept that number for me. Okay, so what are people's pleasure in terms of going forward with this budget? Do we want to look at anything more closely? Do we want to go forward with this? There's not, as we discussed last time, there's not a lot of fat in here.
I was just trying to go through and look and see, could we pull, can you try to take some of that 90,000, and take it out of.
And what would that do? I mean, we do have three contingency students, so that's roughly $30,000, $10,000 per student, just roughly. We have, we want to keep investing in technology, but that's also a big chunk. If we cut the Chromebooks by four and the smart boards by one, we would save. I know Tom's against that. I'm just saying, about 15,000. Just saying.
What big building repairs did we have for this year?
Right, we're doing some of those.
We actually do not put too many big ones in here, but the biggest one we put in there was the phone and bell system. I believe we also put in, the safe and secure doors, correct?
Yeah.
So that's something we could say, you know we're getting extra money, extra, I mean, we're getting unanticipated revenue, in essence, this year from the SAU fund balance.
It's an expense, you're saving an expense line, it's not a revenue.
Right, I'm sorry, we're not getting unexpected revenue, we're saving our expense line, and we know that it's $16,800. So we could perhaps say, let's pull out safe and secure doors, which is estimated at $15,000.
13.
13 now, so we could pull that out. And that would bring it down by $13,000, so.
I mean, I'd like to, as much as possible, not, I mean, try to lower that $90,000, to ask the town for that, I mean, I think, if we can do it, we should try.
It's in the 2630. It's on the maintenance repairs.
Yeah, do we have itemized?
Well, Kate gave us the list at the last meeting.
Right.
So I have it. You want to see it?
I think it's this, yeah.
It's in here.
That's it.
Yeah, but she revised it.
Okay.
This is the revised one that she, this is the number you see, the $72,000 in that line, that's what it makes up.
Oh, yeah, so, and the other, so the other things that were in there were, I mean, unfortunately, the phone and bell system came in much higher.
Right.
So, but, which is one of the reasons the actual budget went up a little higher too, on version two. But we could bring it down by 13 by simply saying we'll do safe and secure doors this year, knowing that we have some.
What about vehicle services?
For next year?
Is this the new one?
No, it's yours.
No, we changed that to zero. It's flat.
Oh, I feel better.
It's flat, yeah, legal services is flat.
We changed that. You gotta look at this version.
Yeah, I know. This looks very more colorful, it's providing all kinds of opportunities.
Yeah, I mean, so you took the door, and your door gives $20,000 back. And if we had a contingency, that's $30,000.
So what did you say, do you smart board instead of?
Yeah.
That's $70,000, right? It's the door.
Very well.
That's $13,000, so that's $20,000, and then contingency, we're down $30,000, and that makes $90,600, which is $45,000, which is $0.30 instead of $0.45.
What was your middle thing?
The doors.
The doors?
Only three smart boards instead of four, and then cutting a contingency student.
Because we have three?
We have three.
Do we know what we added this year?
Three. I kept the flat.
No, do you know how many students?
For real life.
I have to look. And it's not, yeah, and that could fluctuate.
Yeah.
People could come in and go in, yeah, I have to look. So you reduce it by three smart boards?
No, just, yeah, by one. So the conversation is about reducing by one smart board. One smart board is $7,300.
Right, currently we have four budgeted.
Four budgeted. Safe and secure doors, that's $13,000. And one contingency student you're thinking of, so that's another $10,000-ish.
So that would knock a little more than $30,000.
Can any of those other general maintenance items? I mean, it just says general maintenance, I don't know, that's just.
Where are you here with that?
Anticipated, or that, or.
General maintenance, well, it's.
That just come up, things that come up.
I think that's pretty flat.
Okay.
The general maintenance, I'm not 100% sure, let me.
The general maintenance is the same line.
Yeah, it's the same.
It's the same line, and it adds up to the 70, all that list adds up to 72.
I know,
correct.
But there's $10,000.
Yeah.
I mean, you really, Kate's not here, I can't speak on that.
I know.
I'm just looking here.
Well, it's got all those, some of the warrant articles are in there, so you can look at that.
It's hard to tell with that.
And then we, and then the board for record to do additional stuff with that one.
Right.
Why don't we pull the, the other parts out? The bell and phone system. How much did that?
Twenty-seven, that's a.
So what if we were to do that as a warrant?
We could.
I just don't wanna, I don't wanna get rid of these things. They're not frills. I mean, this is, you know, unnecessary thing.
Right, no, I know.
That way we're, you know, we don't have to go through the whole ridiculous review process, so, you know, it is what it is. It's necessary. It's a safety issue.
Yeah, the bells and the phones, absolutely. Yeah, I mean, we can, if we talk about everything at once, we're also thinking about having a warrant for the annex roof, for the roof area that we're sitting in. And that's close to $100,000. We do need to get more bids on that. As far as I know. So I don't know what people think about having a warrant article for $27,000.
Oh, you could put the door and the doors and the that phone system on the same warrant, couldn't you?
For separate purposes.
It's still security though, isn't it? I mean, I don't.
Well, I don't know either. I think warrants have to be relatively specific. But. And we could do the and we can do the doors this year with the excess from the SAU.
I just want to make sure. Okay, well, I just don't want them to go by the wayside. They need to be done. Was there some sort of study done recently, or do we get what prompted that?
The fact that the doors don't lock reliably, and there was something else too. There was a. You don't remember? I think the alarm system needed to be updated, and they wanted to alarm. Not all the doors are alarmed, and not all of them are able to. You know, they're locked, but they're not all alarmed or something. Maybe the kindergarten entrance. There was more to
something about kindergarten.
Yeah.
And also the phone system as well.
And intercom, the phone intercom.
Yeah.
I don't know why it's always open.
What's that? Okay, please don't say it. It's being taped. Whatever we know about security in this building, please don't mention it. So, I mean, those are suggestions to get it down $30,000.
You know what? Just as a thought, you know, I understand that, you know, that revenue issue was not expected, but, you know, we still have things to do, and regardless, I mean, this stuff was really no frills. So, I'm not sure I'd want to go much more. I think if we could possibly, you know, put in something on a warrant, as opposed to include it right here and giving people a choice, I think it's a smart, you know, decision to vote for it. But at least we're, you know, not including it all in this budget and trying to take some of the meat off it. But I would not be in favor of taking anything else out. I think we really we've cut this thing to the bone.
So
pretty soon we'll be in the marrow.
So by anything else, do you mean considering Emily's and then putting the doors on a warrant?
I thought we had already, that was was already accounted for.
The doors.
Yeah.
The doors are already accounted for.
Right, right.
Because we said we would do it this year based on the windfall.
Well, I guess I.
Which isn't really a windfall.
The discussion I would want to have is whether or not to put the phone bell system on a warrant or keep it in the budget.
So, what's really tough is that we know for the last few years, and this and the budget for this year that we're working on, so this gets a little confusing, not looking at next year's budget, that we have always had a little bit of money that we've been able to spend at the end of the year. If we have $30,000 at the end of the year, we would spend it on the bell and phone system, if we had it. But we don't know that we're going to have it. That's the big problem. We just don't know.
If we put on a warrant article, we can't.
It will be taxed, right. I mean, it will be raised by taxation. That money will be raised.
No, but what I mean, if we put it on a warrant article, the town votes it down.
And they vote no, we can't.
Use our budget to do that.
That is correct.
Excess.
That is correct.
So that's.
So that's, it puts us in a.
Well, then I say we go forward with the, whatever, it's almost 60,000 increase in our expenses a year. It is what it is. I mean, we really don't have a lot of fluff here.
Yeah. I mean, so that's taking Emily's suggestions, right?
Yes.
You mean?
Yeah, you brought it down. How much was it?
Yeah,
30. Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
So bring it down
minus
260.
Minus a smart board, minus safe and secure doors, minus one contingency student.
Which I think we're really kind of rolling the dice with that, but.
Contingency?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah,
I think we're all playing with fire, but.
We're going to have to pay for it one way or another.
That's right. That's
yeah,
right.
And that's, I guess, that's where I'm feeling it's not.
I would not be in favor of going any further, though.
Sixty's a lot better than 90.
Mm-hmm. This is true.
Wait, what do we have from 16 from the SAU?
Yeah, 16.8. 16.8.
And the other
thing I would like us to talk about encumbering this year, so not putting it, is we have a $5,000 estimate on repairing the cupola. And it's $5,000, and it's looking worse and worse and worse.
It looks dangerous.
Every time you walk in. And
we were talking about
I think we should just grab that. My personal thing is we grab that right now.
Yeah.
If they can start working on it,
do it.
Get it done totally.
Yeah, I agree. I think we just need to just address it.
So that would be this. We can talk about that again at our December meeting.
Yeah.
I'll
make the motion then.
And maybe we sort of encumber the money and do it. And, like how much we have already left over? Is that what you're, possible?
This year seems long already.
Right? I know.
Why don't we just
really
run another bus or something?
Well, I was just thinking, like, what are the chances we can do the LED lights this year? It's $5,000. Can we?
Well, it is.
But
it is possible. We don't
right.
know.
I mean,
is there at this point anything's possible?
Did anyone like? Is there? Efficiency program through the state to switch it.
That is, Dick did that the first time around, and the lights, almost all the bulbs were replaced at a pennies on the dollar kind of thing. But it is not available because
because we're replacing that.
Yes, we're not replacing incandescent to this. We're replacing LED with LED. So I think that was the explanation.
Yeah.
Well, I think something is better than nothing, for sure. I was just trying to see.
Anything
at all.
Well, I mean, yeah, but it's all rolling the dice, right? I think that historically we have not used a whole lot of legal. But next year is the year we're going to start negotiating again to extend the contract with Marshwood, so we're going to have more
we will have a lot more legal expenses at that point. So I wouldn't recommend that we cut legal services in the future budget. Right, just because.
May I ask you a question, Marie, about the equipment maintenance agreements? So, this is two, right? Two. So.
That's kind of.
Every year we're paying, it's okay, so I just wanted to make sure that that's like a set number, that we're all of these are pretty much set. Okay, cool.
Well, someone says it's based on actual.
Right. I just wasn't sure if this is like.
Could it deviate from that? Absolutely. Because I'm looking at history, you know, what we've used, but, yeah.
Maintenance agreement, though.
Yeah.
So that number, is that like an amount we pay at like at the beginning of the year?
No, it's based on utilization of how many copies are being made.
Okay.
So you have a copy, you pay, there's two lines.
Right.
One is the copy lease.
Yeah.
And then every time you make copies per page, there's a fee for that. So look at.
You pay a fee per page.
You pay per page.
Well, we're leasing.
Well,
why do we have to lease?
Even if you're not leasing, there's even if you're not.
Well, there's cost for it.
That's right.
Right, that's right. There's ink, there's electricity.
So I looked at, in 16 you spent $7,300, in 17 you paid $8,100. We budgeted $10,000 a year.
So
I just reduced it to $8,000.
Yeah, that's I just wanted to make sure.
Yeah, and the fact that we're saving over $4,000 on testing services, so the more we do in-house, probably the more we have to print ourselves, the more we have to do things, so.
The Chromebook, iPad, but like for what we lose, it's not worth.
Right.
It's
yeah.
not,
I mean, it's not like they're not getting used.
It's not worth the money that we save off the budget. I mean,
right. And I looked at like four Chromebooks because our highest
right.
our class is coming up. There are about 21 kids, so if we cut four Chromebooks. But it's not a ton of money to cut four Chromebooks.
Well, that's
Chromebooks.
It. Like between
yeah.
everything I was thinking about cutting, it's $5,800.
Yeah.
That's,
yeah.
It's not worth.
Right, and I'd also want to
reducing the educational value.
Yeah, here we go. I mean, that's what we're taking
exactly.
right into areas we
yep.
don't want to go.
Well, that's yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, I think we've been pretty responsible. You know, we're sticking to 2% increase for folks who are not covered by the union. I thought we were responsible with everything, and now we've found ways to bring it down a little bit more. So. It was that hit on the revenue that just.
Well, we've still got a few, you know, we've got the roof. We've got to get that taken care of. And I really am grateful we're not taking out that bell and phone system, because that's a lifeline.
That's,
we can't do that.
I think that's very important.
Yeah. I mean, I wanted to. Give folks an opportunity to, well, they're not, but you know, knowing this town, they'll think no, and then you'll have
no
updated.
No, you never know. Yeah. Yep.
Actually, you do.
All right. So to recap, you have it down.
So I'm just going to review.
Yeah. Okay.
One smart board at $7,300.
Mm-hmm.
Just take out the secure doors at $13,000. That's listed on there,
mm-hmm.
and take out one contingency.
That's correct.
Okay, and full disclosure, it's not a lot of money, but we got the updated rate for the property liability and unemployment. It's less than what's in here. I'll adjust it. It's maybe $1,000. It's insignificant, but I'm just full disclosure. I'm going to adjust it accordingly.
Yeah, so it's going to be down. Okay.
Well, good. That's one more thing.
There's a Chromebook.
Yeah,
yes,
there's a Chromebook. I'm sorry, there's three Chromebooks.
Absolutely.
Right.
So that's good news.
Well, there's three Chromebooks. We want to take three Chromebooks out.
I really love that.
Oh, no, no. We don't want to leave them as Chromebooks.
No way.
Yes.
No way.
We want them as our Chromebooks. Okay. Right. The budget will come down.
I also want to ask Kate, like, what if they were spelled out, you know, with the iPads on there and.
Yes, that, well, what?
I think she did.
It's right here.
Yeah.
It has 15.
Yeah.
15 iPads.
It's all on here.
Right, but before I just said, let's, you know, I.
Yeah, it's essentially the replace, this is the, all this up here, all of the technology line is the technology 5-year plan that we saw, well, some of us saw a couple of years ago. And this is following that plan to repair, to replace technology and keep it up to date as we go along. Okay, I think that's it then, thank you. Let's see, was there, so just to sort of recap a little bit, we are thinking of probably a warrant article of about, probably is the amount, 100,000 for the annex. And I don't know if it can be written as up to 100,000 or whatever it is, but I don't know. I think you have to raise exactly, maybe I'm going to suggest that Kate, or that Dick get in touch with Murphy Roofers. I don't know if he's talked to Murphy Roofers, and Kate's not here to let us know, but those are the roofers the town uses, and they gave a very good price to the town for the town hall. Okay? Even though they had to bring in a crane and stuff, they gave a very good price, and Suzanne suggested. We could put in the $100,000 and put Ken, and then when you get to revised number, because those warrant articles don't have to be in until the end of January.
Okay.
But so the board could inform the community that this is what the intent is, you're going to get more confirmed numbers, and then that warrant article will be adjusted more accurately to what the, updated.
Excellent, thank you.
I mean, you could do that,
yeah.
I'm just suggesting.
Yeah.
Just to have it as a holding spot.
Yeah, so 100,000 is the holding spot, because our current, I think we've only had one bid, and it's in the 90s. I forget what you said. The other, with no tax impact warrant article, is I'm going to suggest to all of us here that we don't put anything further in our SPID special fund. What is it called? We have about 150,000 in there now. And again, we jumped through hoops to use it, but we have that as our backup. But that we do continue to put money into our building fund, because that can be used as a building fund. We just have to then have a warrant article, you know, a year from now, 2 years from now, to take it out and use it for something. Mm-hmm. And we have about 100,000 in that, 103,000 in there right now. And I'm thinking of something, a lot. I'm thinking of putting in like up to $75,000. We've got some big ticket items coming up in the future. If we have 75,000 left, who wants to put it in? But that's a lot, so let's think about that a little bit. We don't have to do warrants completely, but definitely at least, I would say at least 50. Mm-hmm. And maybe more if, as we look at it again in a couple of weeks when we have our board meeting.
I'll put building fund warrant article to be determined.
Yes.
Amount to be determined,
yep.
Right?
And we want to use a portion of that for the roof?
We only have 100,000 right now, and we have we have $400,000 items coming up, heating, ventilation,
bigger
homes. Okay, and hopefully we'll have a collective bargaining agreement also to put on, but we'll see. Okay. All right. Does that conclude our budget workshop, people?
Yes.
All right, then we are going to go into an official non-public, and we will discuss negotiations. So I guess we need a motion to go into non-public.
Make a motion to go into non-public.
Second.
One of those seconds.
Judy Nelson.
Yes.
Tom Coons.
Yep.
Aaron Kavanaugh. Here. Andrea Anderson.
Here.
Emily Leach.
Okay. Okay.